Dear experts, welcome. In this webinar, you will learn how to evaluate dissemination, exploitation, and communication in Horizon Europe proposals. Every year, researchers funded by the European Union produce a substantial number of research results. In order for these results to benefit society, they must be made available to the relevant stakeholders and be further used to generate impact. Dissemination and exploitation are two key activities to diffuse knowledge, increase the uptake of research and innovation project results in the Union, and demonstrate the generated impact of the projects funded. Building on Horizon 2020, dissemination, exploitation, and communication continue to be indispensable in the design, evaluation, and implementation of Horizon Europe projects. Let's see what exactly we mean by dissemination, exploitation, and communication. Horizon Europe defines dissemination as the public disclosure of the results by appropriate means other than resulting from protecting or exploiting the results, including by scientific publications in any medium. In other words, with dissemination, we want the beneficiaries to bring their project results to the attention of targeted communities that could further utilize them. Exploitation, on the other hand, is the actual use of results in further research and innovation activities, including, among other things, commercial exploitation, creating and providing a service, or in standardization and policy-making activities. And finally, communication entails all relevant activities aiming to promote the action itself and its results to a multitude of audiences, including the media and the public. As such, the focus of dissemination and exploitation is on the project results, i.e., all output generated by the project during implementation. This may range from publications, software and prototypes, to policy recommendations, development of educational materials, etc. However, Horizon Europe projects are encouraged to define and prioritize their key exploitable results, i.e., their main interesting results, with high potential for exploitation and impact in any field. What are the legal obligations? The main provisions for dissemination, exploitation, and communication are stated in the Horizon Europe regulations. The specific requirements that applicants need to take into consideration when preparing their proposal are found in Article 39. In brief, applicants must submit a draft plan of their dissemination and exploitation activities, including communication measures, together with the target communities addressed. So why do we ask you to evaluate dissemination and exploitation as part of a Horizon Europe proposal? Evidence has shown that dissemination and exploitation facilitates the project's pathway to impact, advances knowledge production and circulation, and supports a more robust evidence-based policy-making. However, a lesson learned from Horizon 2020 is that for many beneficiaries, dissemination and exploitation is thought to be a post-project activity, hence not truly part of the project design. Under Horizon Europe, our ambition is to foster a mentality change and to encourage projects to move away from a tick-box approach for dissemination and exploitation. This is why applicants are requested to place emphasis on dissemination and exploitation from the very beginning. Now, on the practical side, how does dissemination and exploitation feature in the proposal template? Unless the work programme states otherwise, applicants are asked to provide a first version of their dissemination and exploitation plan, and this is an admissibility condition. This plan is not required for applications at the first stage of two-stage procedures, and some proposers, for example those applying in response to a European Research Council call or the Marie Sklodowska-Curie Actions Co-Fund programme, are exempted from this obligation. In other cases, depending on the requirements of the work programme, Market-oriented projects may be further requested to include an exploitation strategy detailing the expected path to commercialization. You will evaluate this first version or draft dissemination and exploitation plan against the impact criterion and its contribution to the project impact pathway, particularly sections 2.2 and 2.3. In section 2.2, applicants are invited to provide free, unstructured text. In section 2.3, applicants are invited to summarize the key elements in their project impact pathway by filling in an impact canvas. Let's now examine more closely how you will evaluate the draft dissemination and exploitation plan. You are asked to check the suitability and quality of the presented dissemination, exploitation, and communication measures to maximize the expected project outcomes and impacts in line with the work program requirements. In particular, the following aspects should be taken into consideration. The dissemination and exploitation and communication measures should be proportional to the scale of the project and should contain concrete actions to be implemented, both during and after the end of the project. For example, imagine that a project proposal suggests the development of a novel forecasting model that could proactively manage passenger flow. Potential dissemination and exploitation measures could include targeted events, scientific publication with the results of a demonstration phase, patenting the algorithmic model, etc. However, if the latter is licensed at a higher cost than the projected revenue increase, the exploitation measure may not be successful enough in creating interest for uptake by the air industry. If this is the case, the score will be lowered. The scale and significance of contributions to outcomes and impact of a project should be linked to the expected results and the dissemination and exploitation measures proposed for those results. In our example, the proposal could mention if a trial with airports could lead to a subsequent adoption of the proposed solution by the airports taking part in the trial and possibly by other airports. The proposal should also mention the benefit for the air travel sector. For example, how much the passenger capacity in European airports is expected to increase if the proposed solution is adopted. If the applicants provide this information, the score will be higher. The causal mechanism. How the proposed dissemination and exploitation measures can help the project results transform into concrete socio-economic impact. In our case, by patenting and licensing the algorithmic model of the solution to targeted airports, there would be higher potential for better passenger management, fewer virus superspreader events in airports, etc. Let's consider now the target groups which could make use of the project results and outputs. That is, the scientific community, policymakers, financial actors, the public at large, and other end users should be identified. In our example, the proposal could consider specific European airports or the European Union Aviation Safety Agency as potential users of the proposed solution. If the target groups are identified, the score will be higher. In addition, if exploitation is expected primarily in non-associated third countries, applicants should describe how the proposed exploitation process is still in the Union's interest. In our case, if the exploitation of the solution is proposed to take place in Senegal, the proposal could highlight that the proposed solution is going to affect positively the European companies using Dakar Airport as a transit hub. Last but not least, applicants should explain how intellectual property rights and data management are expected to support the exploitation of their project results. In our example, the scientific publication of the project results should be transparent and accessible not only to the scientific community but also to the air industry stakeholders. Remember that not only the standard market-oriented projects are expected to detail their dissemination, exploitation, and communication measures, but also projects falling within the academic discipline of social sciences and humanities, or SSH. SSH projects are equally expected to detail their dissemination, exploitation, and communication measures unless the work program states otherwise. This is also applicable for projects expected to produce results that could contribute to policy making and/or policy programming. If applicants do not provide concrete information, the score will be lowered. In a nutshell, applicants are requested to describe their planned dissemination, exploitation, and communication measures as part of their project pathway to impact. The proposed measures should cover both the project implementation lifecycle and beyond. The target user communities should be clearly indicated. Overall, dissemination and exploitation should be seen as an opportunity for the success of a project and not as an administrative obligation. We now come to the end of this video. Thank you for your attention and for your valuable evaluation work.